Hello students, hope you all are fine. Today we are going to start with unit 2, second chapter, that is the Sovereigner, on your textbook page number 24. First, let us see what is the meaning of Sovereigner. Sovereigner means a thing that is kept as a reminder of a person, place or event. It is also called as momentum. So, traveling in space is known as a space exploration, which means the action of exploring an unfamiliar area. So, I hope you have understood what is the meaning of Sovereigner. Okay. Now, let us see who has written this lesson. This lesson is written by Lakshman Londe. Now, Lakshman Londe was a noted novelist and he has written this in a science fiction in Marathi. He was a part of a modern Marathi literacy movement of popularized science in the last 1970 with a group of authors rising the prominence, including Bal Phadke, Niranjan Ghate, Jaivant Nirkar and several others. He was born on 3rd October 1944 and he died on 6th August 2015. Now, the books he has written were Dusra Elsten, Second Elsten means, and it was written in Marathi, and this story is taken from that novel only. So, let us start with our chapter on page number 24. With the tip of her nose pressed to the window of the space shuttle, Siley said, gazing at the view outside for so long. Now, this girl Siley, she was sitting on the window and she was gazing outside. Gazing means looking outside, okay? Still, she did not seem to be contented. Contented means not satisfied. She had read the description of this view several times before and had seen this scene on the video too. Now, as she has read in books and she had never seen the location or the scenery in reality. Now, as she was traveling, she was seeing this all in reality. But this was different. Reading the description was one thing, watching the picture and videos captured by the camera was the another. But getting an opportunity to view that amazing panorama with your own eyes, being presently physically right in the midst of it, was indeed an out-of-world experience. Now, as she had read it, now this space means she was going on the moon. Okay, so she was what? She was very happy, and she had run. She had read. She had seen the videos and she had not seen in reality. Now she was sitting in space shuttle and she was moving where? On moon. So she was seeing all this with her own eyes. So what she is telling? An out of the world. And it was what? The out of the world. This is what? This is one of the phrase. And meaning of out of world is extraordinary or not found on the earth. So it was very extraordinary experience. So she was feeling very happy and she was very excited to see all the things in reality. That is what when she was traveling in the space shuttle. Okay, I hope you have understood this first paragraph till here. Now let us continue with that first paragraph only. No matter how long she sat gazing, her awe and wonder did not seem to abate. Now, she was sitting in the space shuttle and she was gazing. Her awe. What do you mean by awe? That is amazement. And wonderful and wonder did not seem to abate. Abate means to reduce. Okay. She was very, very excited and her amazement was not reducing only. Okay. The earth gradually appeared to get smaller and smaller in the sky. As the space shuttle was going up, the earth was getting what? Smaller and smaller. The azure blue sky was now looking jet black. Now, azure means clear blue color. Okay, the sky was looking what? It started looking black. The clouds had disappeared. The stars were shining bright. The cloud has also disappeared and the stars were shining now bright. This trip to the moon was extraordinarily expensive, but still Siley's mother had sent her on the trip. Now, this trip to the moon was what? Extraorbitally. Extraorbitally means it was very excessive and it was very expensive. Expensive means it was very the students have to pay more money, so expensive. But still, Siley's mother had sent her on the trip. But Siley's mother, she sent Siley to the trip. In our childhood, we cannot even think of such long distance trip. Now, her mother was telling to her that in their childhood, they were not allowed and they were not ready to think about so long distance trip. The longest trip meant going to Europe. Now, what she said, the longest trip in our childhood was what? It was only going to Europe. If you are getting this opportunity, make the most of it, said mummy. Now, what did the Siley's mummy said her? If you are getting the opportunity to go on the moon, so you should not miss this opportunity and you should go to visit the space. Okay, I hope you have understood this. Now let us start with the next stanza. Oh mummy, Neha's grandmother was saying that in their childhood, the longest trip for the school children used to be only up to Delhi or Kolkata. It seems so funny, isn't it? Said Siley laughingly. Now, what did Siley answered his mummy? She said that Neha's grandmother, her friend's grandmother, was telling that our picnic used to go to what? Till Delhi or Kolkata. And she started laughing. Who? Siley. Remembering the incident made her laugh even now. Now, this all thing she was what? She was thinking when she was sitting in the space shuttle. Okay. Now, the shuttle was gently closer and closer to the moon. Then it started orbiting the moon. Now, the shuttle was what? Very close to the moon and it started orbiting. Orbiting means taking what? Circles. Okay. In every 32 minutes, the shuttle completed one revolution round the moon. Now, after every 32 minutes, the shuttle completed one revolution. So, it was taking a round near the moon in 32 minutes. Okay. So, orbiting means to take a circle. This word you had heard in geography, orbiting. Okay. So, I hope you have understood till here. Let us see with the next stanza of the same lesson on page number 25. Light and darkness followed each other in quick succession. Now, light and darkness was there continuously. Succession means following in sequence. The dome-shaped settlement on the moon, which resembled the igloos of Eskimos, were now visible. Now, the dome-shaped settlements on the moon, there was what? Dome-shaped settlements were there and it was resembling like what? It was resembling like igloos and of the Eskimos, and they were now what? Visible. After some time, Siley's shuttle made a slow, measured and safe landing on the moon. After some time, the shuttle was slowed down and they were safely landing on the moon. The door of the shuttle was opened and the children were escorted through an airtight tunnel to the settlement at the Neil Armstrong base. Now, as the shuttle was stopped, the shuttle was opened and the children were escorted. What do you mean by escorted? Escorted means carefully accompanied. Okay, they were accompanied by the airtight tunnel to the settlement at Neil Armstrong base. Okay, so they were get down over there. Okay, now the receptionist at the entrance to the base gave some instruction at a very outset. Now, the receptionist means what? What do you mean by receptionist? Receptionist means a person who is sitting, who greets and deals with the visitor. Okay, so she was giving what? She was giving the instruction at a very outset. Outset means start. Okay, so let us see the next stanza. I welcome you all to the Neil Armstrong base. Now, what the receptionist was telling, she was welcoming everyone at that place. And what was the name of the place? Neil Armstrong base. To make your stay on the moon pleasant and comfortable, I would like you to take certain precautions. Now, what she was telling? She was telling, if you want to make your stay very pleasant and comfortable, she was going to say, tell some precaution and that they should follow the all instruction. Listen carefully to my instruction and please follow them during your stay. She said you should follow this all instruction till the time you are on the moon. You know that the gravitational force of the moon is 1/6 that of the earth. Now she said that you all know that the gravitational force of the moon is what? 1/6 of the earth. In the human settlement on the moon, a gravitational force is equivalent to that of the earth has been artificially maintained. Now what she said, as this human settlements are there on the moon, so the gravitational force are equivalent to that of earth has been artificially maintained, okay? But outside those settlement, the gravitational force of the moon is at work. She said that if you will go outside this place, then there the gravitational force of the moon is on the work. You will have to be extremely careful when you roam around there. So she was warning to the students that you should be very careful if you will leave this settlement and if you will go on to the moon. So you have to be what? Very careful, and you have to roam around there very properly. Okay. The second point to remember is related to shopping on the moon. You all must be interested in carrying souvenirs back home from the moon. Now what she said, the second point, you should keep in mind while you are shopping. So she was telling that everyone will be what? Very much excited to take something from the moon. That is what souvenir. Souvenir, as I said, souvenir means what? A thing that is kept or bought as a reminder of something. So please buy the articles only from the shop which are inside the dome-shaped settlement. What she said that if you want to purchase anything, you should purchase from the dome-shaped settlement. There you will be assured of genuine article. What she said, if you want to take any article, you will get that article from there is genuine. What do you mean by genuine? Genuine means real. Okay. Do not buy anything from the unauthorized shop outside the settlement. What she said, that if you want to buy anything, you should buy everything from an genuine shop, and that should be purchased from what? Inside the settlement. I wish you a very happy and pleasant stay on the moon. So she wished everyone to have a pleasant stay on the moon. Let us see the next paragraph. Same page number 25. A jam-packed 3 days program awaited the children on the moon. Now all students were anxiously waiting for the 3 days program on the moon. According to the earth calculation on the moon, there were 15 days of daylight and 15 days of night time. Now according to the earth calculation, as we know, we had studied in geography that 15 days on the moon, there is daytime, and 15 days they were the time of night. The 3 days of the trip were going to be the part of night time on the moon. Now the 3 days the students have gone, that days are going to come in which time? Night time. Okay. One of the most important program of the first day was sky watch. Now the first program on the moon was what? Sky watch means to see the sky. On the earth it was usually foggy and the stars were seen rarely and only very faintly. Now when we see the stars from the earth, in the sky, what we see? We see usually the sky looks foggy. Foggy means not clear. Okay. And the stars also looks what? Very faintly. There was no atmosphere on the moon. On the dark background of the moon sky, the stars shone dazzling bright. Now there was no atmosphere on the moon, and I said you that the 15 days was what? About the night time. So there was what? Dark background on the moon sky, and the star shone dazzling bright. And the star was what? Dazzling. Dazzling means extremely bright. Okay. And foggy means unclear. So the star shone dazzling bright. Bright, you know, bright means what? Very dark. Okay. So dazzling. What is the meaning of dazzling? Extremely bright. So the stars were looking what? Very bright on the moon sky. I hope you have understood till here. So turn your page and come to page number 26. We'll continue the next paragraph, that is, the most attractive view was that of the disk of the earth. In the moon sky, the earth looked 13 times bigger than the moon in the earth sky. Now the most attractive view on the sky was what? Disk of the earth. Okay. And the moon sky, the earth looked 13 times bigger. Now from the moon, the earth was looking what? 13 times bigger than the moon in the earth sky. it was also 70 times brighter, and it was looking what? The earth was looking brighter also. The earth light fell on the moon. The earth light was falling on the moon. This beautiful, enchanting view made Sylee and her friend ecstatic. Now, this view, it was very beautiful view and enchanting. Enchanting means very beautiful, okay? It was very beautiful. And ecstatic, ecstatic means view made Sylee and her friend ecstatic. Ecstatic means very happy, extremely happy. They feel asleep, feeling happy, excited and comfortable at the same time. By seeing that view, they were what? They were feeling very ecstatic, that is very extremely happy. And by seeing that view, they fall asleep, and they were what? Very excited also and comfortable at the same time. The second day's attraction was the circus on the moon. One unique feature of the circus was the seating arrangement. The second day was going to start, and what was the attraction of the second day? That was circus on the moon. And one unique feature of the circus was the sitting arrangement. What do you mean by unique? Unusual, okay? So what was the unique feature of the circus? The sitting arrangement. The spectators were made to sit in the tent, and the circus was going on outside. Now all the spectators or the persons who were going to see the circus, they were sitting what? They were sitting in the tent, and circus was going outside the tent. High jumps and long jumps were the special attraction. And what was the main attraction? High jump and long jump. One gymnastic jumped 27 meter high. Now one of the gymnastic, he had jumped how many? 27 meters high. On both the days, beside the main attraction, much time was reserved for visiting the various settlements there. Now on the both days, beside this main attraction, most of the time the children were visiting what? The various settlements that was what? That was already settled on the moon. So the students used to roam on that various settlements, and they used to visit all the settlements above this main attraction. It was expected that the students should spend some time for self-study. Now the teachers were expecting that students should do their self-study also on the trip. The teacher had assigned them the task of writing an essay on how they spend their time on the moon. Even the teacher had assigned them one job to write a essay, and what was the name of the topic? How they had spent their time on the moon. Which places they visited, which places they visited, what they observed, what they had seen, etc. Sylee and her friend had traveled far and wide and had done a lot of sightseeing. Now the girl Sylee and her friend, they had traveled what? Far and wide. Now far and wide is what? Again the phrases. Across a large area. Far and wide means what? Across a large area. And had done a lot of sightseeing. And they had seen lot of sights. Okay. The sightseeing means the sceneries or the pictures or the areas where there is lot of what? Attraction or beautifulness. That is what? Sightseeing. So Sylee and her friend, they had traveled far and wide and had done lot of sightseeing. Okay, let us see the next stanza on same page number 26. On the third day, the teacher took them to a place of historical importance. Now the third day was started, and teacher took them on the historical important places. 100 years ago, Neil Armstrong had landed at this place. Now the teacher took them to the place where 100 years ago the first astronaut has landed, where on the moon. At that place the teacher had took them. Everyone was looking forward to this visit to the historical monument. Now everyone was waiting when the teachers were going to take to that area. Okay, it was the oldest place in the history of the man on the moon. And it was the what? It was the very oldest place in the history of the man on the moon. The first footprint of Neil Armstrong was preserved on the moon land. And his first footprint was preserved on the moon, where the Neil Armstrong had kept his first feet on the moon. That is already preserved on the moon land. Beside the footprint was a grand statue of Armstrong. And beside this, the statue
of Armstrong has also been made, and it has been also what kept over there. At the base of the statue were carved the first word uttered by a human on the moon, and under that statue there was carving written uttered. It was written, uttered means to say, it was uttered on the human. Human being has what said the first word on the moon, that was what, that was carved on the under the statue. And what was that? One small step for a man, one giant leap of mankind. And what was carved on that? One small step for a man, one small step and one giant leap of mankind. These words were written under the statue. Okay, I hope you have understood till here. Now we will see on page number 27. The next attraction for the children was that they were going to wear the space suit for the first time. Now the next attraction was the children were going to wear the space suit, and they were going to wear it first time. Then they were going to roam outside, experiencing the gravitational force of the moon. Now as the children were in the human settlement, now they were going on the what? They were going to roam outside the human settlement, and they were going to face what? The gravitational force of the moon. Be careful when you walk, dear children. Don't run or sprint, you will fall. Now what the receptionist she was telling that you should be very careful, you should walk very nicely, and you should not run or sprint. What do you mean by sprint? Sprint means a short race at a top speed. Okay, otherwise you will fall. The teacher was warning them repeatedly. Now the teacher was giving warning them, she was giving warning repeatedly. Repeatedly means again and again. But who was in the mood to listen? Now the children were not ready to listen to the teacher. They hoped, jumped and ran around. The children were hoping with joy, and they were running around the moon all the time.
Let us start with the next paragraph on same page, page number 27. Buy ornaments specially made from the stones on the moon, very cheap, cheaper than those available in the shops in the settlement. Now there were one hawker who was shouting. What he was shouting? He was telling that buy the ornaments specially made from the stones on the moon, and it is what, very cheaper. And he was telling, he was comparing that the price of this year, these ornaments are cheaper than the ornaments which are available in the shop in the settlement. Cheaper and better. He was telling what? It is cheaper also and it is better also. At least have a look. And he was telling that at least have a look. The roadside shopkeeper screamed at the top of their voice. And he was who? He was a roadside. You can see na, on the pavement also some people sell the goods. So same way this roadside shopkeeper was screaming. Screaming means he was shouting. Okay. Buy sister, buy. I am selling this earring really cheap. Saying this, he approached Sairi and displayed the set of shining stones earrings. Now he was shouting, and Sairi was going from there. So he saw Sairi, and he started shouting that if you want to buy this. And he showed means showed the set of shining stones earrings to Sairi. Sairi suddenly remembered her mother. Tomorrow they were to start on their return journey. Now as she was standing over there, Sairi recollect, she remembered her mother, and she was thinking that tomorrow we are going back to the home. She had completely forgotten her mother in last 3 days. She felt terribly guilty. Now what she was thinking? She was thinking that I am here from last 3 days and I have totally forgotten my mother. And she was feeling what? She was feeling very guilty. Means she was feeling that as I am here, I am not remembering my mother. Buy this sister, don't think much, cheaper and better, take it. Sairi looked around, the other children had proceeded ahead. Come on, give me those red earrings quick. Sairi pointed at them and asked what is the price. Now that shopkeeper said, don't think so much, it is cheaper also and better also, so take it. And Sairi was what? Sairi was looking around, and the other children had proceeded ahead. The other children who were with her, they went in front. And what did Sairi said to the shopkeeper? She said that give me that red one please, and what is the price? only 1,000 rupees, replied the salesman. What salesman said? It is for 1,000 rupees. Siley immediately paid the amount, took the earring and ran to catch up with her friends. What she did? She gave the money to the shopkeeper and she took the earring and ran to catch up with her friend. She was running to where the friends were going. So she went forward looking at her friends. Okay, I hope you have understood till here. So now the last paragraph of our chapter, same on page number 27 only. So let us continue with that. On returning home, Siley told her mother very enthusiastically, "Mummy, look what I have brought for you." Now they have returned back from the journey and Siley was very enthusiastically means very happily. She told her mother that, "See what I have brought for you." Her mother picked up the earrings. Now her mother took that earrings what she has brought. She exclaimed, hello dear, how am I going to wear such heavy earrings?" Now what her mother said that, "How I will wear such a heavy earrings in my ears?" Siley immediately realized her mistake. Siley had purchased the earrings in the field on the moon's gravity. From where she has purchased? She has purchased from what? Outside the settlement, na? And the already when they were when they went for shopping, at that time the receptionist was telling, if you want to purchase anything, you should purchase from the settlement only, human settlements only, don't purchase from outside. And she realized her mistake because she has purchased the earring in outside the settlement. Okay, I hope you have understood this lesson. It was very nice lesson. And actually this story, as I had told you before only, this is translated from the story Bhet by Lakshman Londe. Okay, so if you have any confusion or any problem, so you have to again listen to this video and continue. Okay, so here we have finished with this chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.